శేషం కుమాపతిం సురగురుం వందే జగత్కారణం వందే పన్నగభూషణం శశిధరం వందే పశూనాం పతిం వందే సూర్యశశాంకవన్నినయనం వందే ముకుంద ప్రియం వందే భక్తజనాశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే భక్తజనాశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే శివం శంకరం. Friends, everybody wants to be happy. It need not be explained. The goal of life is to be happy always. Whichever is a hindrance to our happiness, we avoid it. Whichever is promoting our happiness, we will take it. Walking is difficult. We avoid it. If there is a bicycle, we can go more comfortably. Therefore, instead of walking, we use a vehicle. And while riding the bicycle, we feel comfortable. And one day, I have seen a scooter. Somebody has given me a lift. I am the pillion rider. Oh, what a fool I was. Only the bicycle I had, there is better comfort, greater comfort. Then I find the bicycle to be less comfortable and I prefer a two-wheeler motorbike. After some time, I have seen an ambassador. I traveled by that. What a fool I was all these days. I was satisfied with the motorbike. Now there is a roof above me. There is a greater comfort. There is a more happiness. Wonderful. And somebody gives me an AC car. Wonderful. This is much better than that. So one by one, we search, we seek, we rise to have more and more comfortable life. It's common. It's natural. Similarly, eating, that is comfort, pleasure, the pleasure of eating, the pleasure of smelling fragrance, the pleasure of listening, the pleasure of lying. Everywhere you feel the pleasure. When I am eating rasgulla, wonderful it is. When I am enjoying this car, wonderful it is. When I go by the imported car, oh, wonderful. These are all sense pleasures. Body is comfortable, it is a pleasure to the skin. Nose is comfortable, it is a pleasure to the nose. Tongue is very, very tastily, food is enjoying, and then it is pleasure to the tongue. The five senses of the body would like to have the pleasure of the senses. One day, my daughter is sick. She is suffering from typhoid. Doctors said, hopeless. Somebody brought rasgulla packet. My daughter is sick. She is on the deathbed. Somebody has brought the rasgulla. Rasgulla gives me pleasure. No doubt about it. Can I eat it? She is sick. She is unwell. I love her. She is my child. She is my daughter. When I have the love for the baby, I cannot have the pleasures of the body. Which is better? from the pleasure of the body, you go to the enjoyment of the mind. When the child is playing, when the child is happy, I enjoy the child's play. My daughter from London gives me a phone call, "Daddy, I got university first. I am a rank holder. Oh, I am very, very happy." See, the pleasure, the intensity of the pleasure from walking to bicycle, to scooter, to car, to etc. flight. All these pleasures are nothing when compared to the love I have. When my daughter is sick, all these pleasures I do not want. I cannot have them. So which is better, which is greater, which is superior? Not the sense pleasure. No doubt it is good. But when there is a question of comparison, when I love somebody, that somebody must be happy. Swami Vivekananda, on the 11th of September, he was in Chicago. Food was there. Delicious, tasty food is available. He has not slept. Comfortable cushion is available. He remembered Indians. He loved Indians. Indians then, lakhs and lakhs and crores of them, did not have food, did not have shelter, did not have a bed, did not have clothing. He could not eat. A very simple, common experience. You are in Bangalore city railway station. You have bought a packet of idli. You have opened it. There on the platform, an old beggar, very sickly beggar, who has not eaten for 7-8 days, he looks at you hungrily. You are about to take that idli packet apiece. He is looking. You are about to eat. If you are a human being, you cannot eat. If you are an animal, you will turn this side and eat. There is concern for the fellow human being. And then what will you do? You give a piece of it to him. If you are still more loving, you give toothless to him. If you are still more, you give the complete packet to him. That's karma yoga. Karma yoga is to rise and also to spread. Yoga, it is to rise vertically up from sense pleasure to emotional enjoyment. No doubt we need sense pleasures. Sense pleasures are the lower level. From the lower level of pleasure, we rise to the emotional enjoyment. I give my food to my son. Unless he eats, I cannot eat. Sacrifice. And when that circle spreads, I give it to my neighbors. I give it to my friends. I give it to the entire humanity. So yoga is to rise from the low level of pleasures to the higher level of enjoyment. And simultaneously you spread towards all. Circular. So, horizontally or circularly you spread, vertically you rise. Vivekananda Swami was able to rise from the sense pleasure to the emotional enjoyment. Adi Shankara has gone beyond that. There is intellectual happiness. And that intellectual happiness, a researcher knows. When you go to the laboratory, when you are doing your PhD, when you discover the truth, you do not think of your food. You do not think of your wife. You do not think of your children. You do not think of anything. All your thought is concentrated on only one thing, knowing the truth. Einstein, Sir C.V. Raman, mathematician Ramanujam, all these great stalwarts of intellectual caliber, they have never bothered about food. Karyapuranam na sukham na nidra. When your daughter is sick, you cannot have the pleasures of the body. When you want to serve the fellow human being, you will not be selfish to eat the food. And when you are rising further from the sense pleasure to the emotional enjoyment, from emotional enjoyment to intellectual happiness. And that intellectual happiness is urge to know. Sir C.V. Raman was in his laboratory. He was doing his practicals. He wanted to know the truth, the Raman effects, he was this great discovery. And every day he would get the food carrier, a servant boy of about 19-20 years, he would bring the food to him. Sir C.V. Raman would be in his laboratory. He did not know when he would be thirsty or hungry. Sometimes he would eat at 1 o'clock, sometimes he would eat at 2 o'clock, sometimes he will not eat at all. This boy who brought the food will be waiting for Sir C.V. Raman. He has no other interest. Whatever is eaten by Sir C.V. Raman is eaten. Whatever is left behind, this fellow would eat. Every day, the boy would be eating. Sir C.V. Raman would be doing his practicals. One day, 2 o'clock, Sir C.V. Raman did not come. 3 o'clock, he did not eat. The boy was very hungry. He looked at the old man. Why should I care for him? Why should I wait for him? He took the carrier to the side, opened it, took half of the rice and more of them. Sambar, rasam, chutney, everything he ate, and a little he left and packed it and put it there. About 5 o'clock in the evening, Sir C.V. Raman, after all, it's a body. It felt a little hungry, the body. He came, opened the carrier. He found a little of rice touched by the fingers, a little of sambar. He thought, maybe I have eaten, and he kept it close. He did not remember. Mathematician Ramanujam, his mother served him curd, good food. He was eating. How is food? The mother asked. The square root of 0.00001 is, he was giving the reply. Better, I have given you food. He doesn't remember. Girlfriend comes. How is my sari? Karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga, the four streams of yoga. Brahman, hey, useless fellow, how is my sari? I don't know. Are you a man or a woman? He doesn't know that. Shukha Brahma did not know it. Rishyasringa did not know it. Prahlad was unable to know it. When you are deeply engrossed, not only our people, Professor Einstein, Archimedes, Adi Shankara, when you are thoughtfully engrossed, intellectually involved, your body will not be remembered. Your attachments and the so-called love of the world will not be remembered. They do not know. It is miserable for the wives who marry intellectual jains. They don't remember the wife. Everybody looks like a wife or nobody looks like a wife. That is the greatest personality, intellectual happiness. Now the purpose, you see, sense pleasure, you come to emotional enjoyment. From emotional enjoyment, you come to intellectual happiness. When you come to that intellectual happiness, why can't I give it to everybody? Why can't I give that love to everybody? You spread that love to all. You spread that jnana to all. You are growing vertically. You are spreading circularly. This is a yogi. And finally, after the physical pleasures, after the emotional enjoyment, after the intellectual happiness, he wants total peace, shanti, shanti. And that is after the day's pleasures, day's enjoyments, day's pleasures, you feel like lying and sleeping. Similarly, a yogi feels like withdrawing from all and getting absorbed in total peace. When he loves that peace, when he is involved in that peace, let everybody help. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Let shantir bhavatu. Let everybody be peaceful. Simultaneously you spread. And when that is peace is also abundant, when it grows to its extremity, then it is called Ananda, Brahmananda. Bhoga is Ananda. Enjoyment is Ananda. Happiness is Ananda. Peace is Ananda. And bliss, B-L-I-S-S. So all are Anandas. There is a meter to measure your temperature. There is a meter to measure your heartbeat. There is a meter to measure your blood circulation. There is a meter to measure your BP. Is there a meter to measure your happiness? We are the people to measure it. Sense pleasure is nothing when it is emotionally enjoyed. Prema. For the sake of prema, you give up the bodily pleasures. Mother loves the baby. If she takes rasgulla, if she takes curd, if she takes ice cream, the baby may catch cold, and so she does not. Similarly, Mahatma Gandhiji, he was unable to enjoy the pleasures of the body because many people did not have. He was asked a question, Gandhiji, Gandhiji, why are you always traveling by third class? In those days there was third class in trains, now it is not. And Gandhiji gave the reply, because there is no fourth class. If there is a fourth class, I would have traveled by that lowest. Mother gives everything to the children. If at all anything remains, she gives. Kyaga simultaneously. A yogi grows vertically because there is a higher, higher, higher happiness. Pleasure is the lowest. Only beastly people, only animal-like people, only people of instincts, subhuman species. A dog comes. You are an idiot. You are a scoundrel. You are eating in my house. It doesn't bother. It will warn you. A boy comes, he has passed his MSc, he has got his PhD, he went to the market of employment, he did not get the job. Initially, father was paying money for his application sending, father was paying money for his interview attending, and 4, 5, 6, 7 times he failed. Father lost all interest. That useless dog, unemployed dog, very sick, he started scolding and the boy stopped coming home. Deepavali. Father was scolding, mother was always kind. The boy came through the back door to enter into the kitchen and the mother was looking. She prepared payasam for the boy. He was drinking. And the father was sleeping afternoon nap. Now the father says, has that dirty unemployed dog come home? No, 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 mother says. While taking that payasam, one glass fell. Has that dirty dog entered into the kitchen? The boy is sensitive. He doesn't eat. He goes in. Next the dog comes. And the dog is licking the payasam. And the father scolds, mother scolds, the dog does not go. Only animals are indulging in the sense pleasures. Sensitive people, human people with fellow feeling, with concern for the society, how can we remain to be instinctively indulgent in only the sense pleasures of the body? Gandhiji, Gautamadi Buddha, and the great personalities all over the world, they have given up because they have concern. A yogi is unselfish. At the same time, he rises from the lower level to the higher level, spreading what he has got. The yoga is to rise from a lower pleasure to the higher happiness. And finally, we are absorbed in Brahmananda. If you taste the happiness of a car, you don't come to cycle again. If you taste the happiness of prema, you don't come to the sensual indulgence again. If you taste the intellectual happiness, you don't come back to the lower pleasures. When you are absorbed in shanti, you don't come back to this world. When you enjoy that Brahmananda, a sip of it, a fraction of the second, if you enjoy that Brahmananda in the divine Sakshatkar, you don't feel coming back to this dirty world. Prahlada is like that. Dhruva is like that. You take any conversation when the God wants to give them, I don't want any. I want to remain like this forever in that state of Brahmananda. Higher happiness, higher dimensions are available. Having come to Prashanti, let us not be at the animal level. Let us grow to the human level. From the human level to the superhuman level, physical pleasures, emotional enjoyments, intellectual happiness, peace, and finally Brahmananda. Into that state let us rise and give that state to everybody. And the model is Sri Krishna Paramatma. Let's meditate on him.